În luna martie am petrecut 4 zile din viață într-unul dintre cele mai frumoase locuri de pe pământ, Serengeti, în Ngorongoro din Tanzania. O zonă uriașă de aproape 30.000 de kilometri pătrați împărțită în două. Serengeti, păstrată doar animalelor sălbatice, și Ngorongoro, acolo unde animalele trebuie să-și împartă teritoriul cu oamenii, Masai. În Ngorongoro s-au descoperit cele mai vechi urme ale omului pe pământ, vechi de 3,6 milioane de ani. Dacă oamenii au plecat de aici și s-au răspândit pe tot pământul, înseamnă că aici e paradisul. Am început călătoria noastră în Arusha, la poalele muntelui Meru. Din acest oraș pleacă toate călătoriile de safari în Serengeti și în Ngorongoro. Am plecat dimineață, cu gândul să ajungem până la apusul soarelui în Serengeti, în campul de safari Tortilis. Noi, împreună cu David, ghidul nostru tanzanian și un Land Cruiser de nădejde fără de care nu am fi reușit să le venim de hac drumurilor desfundate din rezervație. Am ajuns la Tortilis însoțiți de un nor de muște și insecte. Fără spray-uri potrivite, ești mâncat la propriu în Serengeti. Se pare că nu animalele sălbatice, ci muștele sunt cel mai mare dușman al omului în Serengeti. Când am ajuns la Tortilis, am constatat că suntem singurii turiști. Din cauza pandemiei, nu mai fusese nimeni în cele 14 corturi ale campului. Următorii vizitatori erau așteptați abia peste o lună. La răsăritul soarelui ne-am trezit în mijlocul unui grup de antilope impala care și-au croit drum prin mijlocul campului. Am plecat din Tortilis pentru a vedea cele mai instagramabile animale din Serengeti. Pentru că a plouat cu două zile în urmă, drumul a fost greu chiar și pentru experimentatul David.
Ngorongoro Crater, before first it became like a crater, it was a mountain, like a huge mountain. And what happened was, about a million years ago, the mountain collapsed. And when the mountain collapsed, it formed this landscape. So if you look around, you will see it's walled. We are surrounded by the wall. And at that time, there was just like lava flowing in here and water depositions. And after that, the soil was formed here, and animals, which were also in Serengeti, migrated in here. There was like an easy movement of animal, like migration from Serengeti to here. And then this place became like locked in. Some animals became like residents of the crater, and that lake was formed. There is a lake there. There are some natural water holes we are going to see on our picnic site. And there are some streams which are coming from that direction and the river. And within the crater, you see there is another small hill. Do you see that one?
Yeah.
Like a Table Mountain, eh?
Yeah.
So actually, back to that name, the crater. The crater name was mistakenly named that way because this is not a crater. It is a caldera.
A caldera, yeah.
Geographically, the crater is formed when the volcano erupts on the mountain. Eruption like that, busting out. But what happened here was collapsion. The mountain collapsed inwards. And the size is a big hole. It's not like an ashy crater. Then in 1951, that's when this place, Ngorongoro and Serengeti, was gazetted as a one big national park. So it was one big national park back. It was contradicting with national park policies. So in 1959, when Tanzania was still under British colonization, the British decided to evict Maasai from Serengeti and move them to the crater. Now the total area of Ngorongoro area is about 8,000 kilometer squares, and Serengeti is 14,763 kilometer squares. So they had to split and move the Maasai people to Ngorongoro area, and they started another conservation strategy, which is called Ngorongoro Conservation Area Authority. It only allowed Maasai people, only Maasai tribe, to stay in Ngorongoro.
To live here, yeah.
To live in Ngorongoro, yeah. So they do a lot of domestic activity, but usually you see them, it's only about livestock keeping. Cultivation is not allowed because at the end of the day, it will bring about negative interaction with the Maasai.
Yeah.
It will attract wildlife to the places, it may not be good. So for what they do is only livestock keeping, and they are moving around everywhere. They are allowed to go everywhere except
the crater. Why is that?
Because there is a higher concentration of animals in the crater. There's tourism activity in the crater, and they have a lot of cows. So the worry was, if there is no easy access of water outside the crater, there will be so many cows here and goats and Maasai people in the crater, where there is a higher concentration of wildlife in here. So there may be a disturbance, plus disturbance in tourism. So imagine you are doing safari here and there are like thousands of cows on the way and there are animals behind the cows. So it brought about some contradictions. So that's why they were told not to come to the crater anymore.
În limba masailor, Serengeti înseamnă câmpiile fără sfârșit. 14.700 de kilometri păstrați de viață sălbatică.